a $5.5 billion project.
From the creator of the Las Vegas groundbreaking New York Casino comes the world's...
I'm Mark Gadvant. I'm the co-founder of Eighth Wonder, also the chairman of the company, and for the past 2 years I've been overseeing the development of the integrated resort...
Incredible location, top-tier amenities of every kind, fine dining, top-flight entertainment, state-of-the-art thrill rides, world-class hotels, sports, shopping, holistic care, environmental adventure, and of course, the very best gaming facilities on Earth.
Our dream for Harry's Island in Sentosa is simple: to create the most exciting integrated resort the world has ever seen. A $5.5 billion project guaranteed to drive visitation and tourism.
Big job, and it needed big people to fill the positions. And it took the energy and passion that Mark and Mark were able to generate in order to attract the world-class people and players that we needed for this project. To use a sports analogy, if we were building a team to compete, in this case, we've built the Dream Team.
The Dream Team is comprised of the most creative minds on the planet, who bring with them unparalleled experience and vision. Engineering a project on the scale of Harry's Island requires the most respected technical minds on the planet. So Dr. Klaus Kleinfeld and the Siemens Corporation have come aboard to design and supply the electronic and mechanical infrastructure on Sentosa.
Siemens is committed to our Eighth Wonder partners.
When it comes to the culinary arts and fine dining, food and beverage, there was only one man to lead the charge. Alain Ducasse, the most renowned chef in the world and holder of 14 Michelin stars.
I'm going to concentrate all of my experiences and expertise on Harry's Island to combine in one place, Alain Ducasse Fine Dining, a hotel and an international culinary school.
When it comes to the production of live entertainment, one name soars to the top of the list. Franco Dragone, the artistic visionary behind Cirque du Soleil, where he created 10 shows, including the most successful on the Las Vegas Strip, O at the Bellagio and Mystère at Treasure Island.
I am Franco Dragone, and I am committed to Eighth Wonder.
From Cirque du Soleil to Dragone Productions, Franco's shows have attracted more people in more countries than any other director in history.
To have the exciting opportunity to create a show, Eighth Wonder, has an amazing vision and energy. Dragone can deliver a creation that will complement such a unique and original destination resort. I am proud to be a part of this elite creative team.
From spectacle to sport, Pelé is the greatest soccer player in the history of the game and one of the world's great humanitarians. It's under his guidance and watchful eye, in his very own stadium on Sentosa, that athleticism will thrive at Harry's Island.
Hello, my friends. It's an honor to me to be part of this project because we're going to have a beautiful football stadium, and football is my game. Football is my life. It's the big sport in the world. But it's not only because we're going to have a football stadium. We're going to have basketball, tennis, and a lot of sport for children. This is the life of sport. I am honored to be part of that.
Exemplary of the commitment of this whole project and this whole entire integrated resort in the Marks is that we have an opportunity to break the mold with this resort and raise the bar and set a new benchmark and do something that is cutting edge and that is meaningful and doesn't just take from the world and the public, but gives back.
A life to understanding well-being in its many manifest and manifold expressions. Physical well-being, emotional well-being, spiritual well-being, economic well-being, ecological well-being. I have sought for a long time to find a place where all these aspects of well-being can be explored
and help temper its collected fear in a time of absolute crisis. While mayor, he also turned New York City into one of the safest cities in the world. Rudy understands at the heart of any development, safety is of paramount concern. That's why he's in charge of security at Harry's Island.
Has to be certain that it sticks with the thing that it's really known for, which is security. And Mark Gadvant and Eight Wonder recognized that from the very, very beginning. And they brought us in, Giuliani Security and Safety, at what is really a very, very early stage. to try and design all of these plans with security in mind, with the right kind of access systems, the right kind of codes, the right personnel. And that will be part of this all throughout this project, from the very beginning to the very end of it, to the implementation stage. We're very committed to it, those of us at Giuliani Security and Safety. We've really enjoyed working on it, and we're looking forward to working on it with all of you as this moves forward.
Part of the strength of the Eighth Wonder team lies in its unprecedented depth of experience. Bob Ward has spent his life designing the world's most famous resort facilities and rides.
25 years at Universal Studios, I've had opportunities to work with some of the most amazing and creative individuals in the entertainment business. I joined Mark Advent's consortium because he has the heart, the vision, and the passion to realize his dream.
Both designed by the renowned architect Peter Marina. Oh, and docked out front are eight of the most captivating motor yachts ever built. Moving east, we're passing over the exclusive mansions by Banyan Tree, also designed by Peter. I have one myself for when my friends stop by. Nestled in the eastern enclave is the Deepak Chopra Center for Well-being, Retreat and Spa. Very tranquil. Rounding the bend now, behold the Hotel Alain Ducasse, an institute for the culinary arts. I call this side of the island the premium, with the Vera Wang Wedding Pavilions, Vera Wang's signature wedding boutique, and her first ever hotel located on the upper floors of the stunning W Hotel. That extraordinary building just across the waterway is the Franco Dragone Theatre. I can't wait to see this creative visionary's live show. Now here we are over the conference center, committed to attracting world-class events and celebrating Singapore as an international destination location. This state-of-the-art facility will be the home for high-profile global conferences and the full-frame documentary film festival, whose advisory board is chaired by my friend, Marty Scorsese. Alongside is the Eighth Wonder Arena, home for exciting concerts, sporting and live events. Designed by one of the world's most beloved architects, Bernardo Fortbrescia of Architectronica, who is also responsible for the Deepak Chopra Retreat, Hotel Alain Ducasse, W, the Vera Wang Establishment, Franco Dragone Theatre, and the Conference Centre. Ever the conservationist, I believe we owe it to Mother Nature and future generations to educate and inform how to take care of our fragile planet, which is why the western end of the island is called Ocean Planet, all designed by the marvelous Walt Geiger and Morris Architects. There's the Explorer Hotel, a true family location, with water park, lazy and whitewater rides, and the most exciting collection of cutting-edge themed attractions. And that's where I live, the Treehouse, with the most fun family suites to be found. For our sea friends, we've created the world's most advanced mammal research and education center next to the Ocean Planet Institute, where we'll be teaching everyone about good world citizenship. And there's the research vessel Singapore One, crafted by Maurique. Moving on, the Star TV Television Studio, where we will produce a vast array of television shows, multimedia and special events, documentaries and edutainment that will reach millions of viewers daily. And there Bernardo goes again. As a crazy South American football fan, imagine his delight at designing Gaal, the world's first soccer hotel, surrounding the amazing Pele Stadium. Directly across from Vivo City is Harry's Island Waterfront, featuring Parties Central, jam-packed with fancy shops, nightclubs and restaurants, where every night there's an amazing free multimedia show on the largest LED screen in Asia. If you're like me, you'll love the capitalist toolbox with everything from the newest, most expensive aircraft, helicopters, cars, and more. And upstairs, the world's first 400 club. Wow, now we're going to the Caldera, where I crash-landed and built Hurricane Harry's Ride Restaurant, another world's first. Sitting in the shadow of my pièce de résistance, Harry's Hideaway. Can you believe it? An actual hotel constructed inside a volcanic mountain. Located just beneath the lagoon is the mind-blowing Caldera Theatre, the site of a free nightly spectacular. All of these architectural wonders were masterminded by Richard Moran and the incredible Gensler Group. The caldera, some say, is the eighth wonder of the world. Now we can see the amazing Grand Palace, where kings, presidents, and heads of state are sure to stay. And in front, the Singapore Aquarium, designed by none other than Peter Shemaev and Bobby Poole. So, that concludes our tour for today. Thanks for joining me and taking a sneak peek at Harry's Island, where it's just one...
During my 25 years at Universal Studios, I've had opportunities to work with some of the most amazing and creative individuals. Has the heart, the vision, and the passion to realize his dreams. There simply is no question, Harry's Island will redefine how all resorts in the future will be created.
Most of the world's major theme parks and resorts charge admission fees and are surrounded by gates, but on Sentosa, Harry's Island will be open to everyone, free of charge.
It would have been wrong to have gated the Sentosa experience. This is about welcoming the world to Sentosa.
As the former president of business development for Universal Studios, Frank Stanek has seen several development proposals for Sentosa over the years.
Through the creativity of the 8th Wonder team, we truly have a project that I can recommend to you. A project that is very complimentary to...
I went to Guam and here to come Canada. And then I asked them to let me stay in the refugee camp with other Vietnamese. Mm. So reunion with the family about 2 months later in Fairfax, Virginia.
You saw the helicopter was pushed
off the deck
of
the
aircraft
area.
Was that
that's
incredible.
You know, they treat me like a hero, like a brother, like that's something, you know. Mm-hmm. I can't understand, but now I understand because I'm a good man. That's it.
Very simple. Actually, I was not his Minister of Foreign Affairs, but I actually got the Vietnamese ambassador to come to my house in Chicago, remember? And we talked about what it would be the protocol for him to come back, how, when. Big election. But I'm glad I did it.
You know, that's a good idea.
So now they really asked me so many things, so many advice. In every field, politics, economy, and this and that. And then, you know, I really help them. I'm very honest, I tell them what's wrong. And so, the things are like 2 years. A lot of changes, you know, they make. According to my advice, something make me feel very happy. I told them, face to face, the Prime Minister, the Minister of this, you know, the chief of police, security, the KGB, your own way of life, your way of thinking are obsolete. The past. Forget them. Get a new direction and build a new country. You know. Now they understand. Economically development, I said, you have to go with America. No. Even China today depend on America. So why you have to go through zigzag through Lee Kuan Yew and Hồ Cẩm Đào? Why go directly to America? Then he asked me, can we trust America? I said, and, you know, the American the ambassador asked me the same thing, can we trust to those stupid communists? I said, it's time that we trust each other, okay? Just start with, you know, trusting each other. So I'm very happy to see Bush coming in, you know, have a good work, you know, for Vietnam, you know. So I think, you know, it's a very good time that our friends in America can come and help. I want to say to them, you know, I'm very upset, you know. Then he said, oh, Lee Kuan Yew, come here and give advice. I said, why do you need Lee Kuan Yew? Lee Kuan Yew is just a mayor.
Abdul Rahman's 80th birthday. Premier and I, we went to...
It's interesting because we're doing some business in Poland.
Yeah.
And Poland has a little bit the same history coming from the communist era. And the Polish people have also a big country. They're 45 million people. And they decided when they joined the EU that they should...
Are you falling in love? No. It was perfect. Okay. Nice to meet you. Please sit down.
Did you get lost?
No.
That way.
Yeah.
My wife
He comes every place with us.
Do you know we have a boy also a boy?
Yes, you tell me. You sent me photos.
It's a chihuahua.
No,
it's
5 million
in America.
Well,
all over
the world.
Europe.
And let's assume that, you know, if they sending, let's assume.
Yeah.
If they sending only $1,000 a year, that's funny. $1,000 a year.
Tạm là hay nhất.
Cao Cúc khu á hồi xưa là định làm là 8.000 hecta, nhưng mà nó quá lớn đi cho nên tụi em quyết định làm 2 hecta, thì trong đó trong 2 hecta để nghiên cứu chỉ làm được khoảng 700 mấy.
Cứ làm cho tôi đi. Nhưng mà tôi bảo đảm nhé, khi mà đã có một tập đoàn thật sự cơ bản nó vào rồi, có thể thấy là phần thứ 10, phần thứ 3 nó như là đàn việc, nó đi theo nhau không ạ? Không, cái nguyên tắc của tôi, cái nguyên tắc đại cơ bản là như vậy. Khi nó bỏ vào 5-7 tỷ, không phải, nó cũng phải cẩn thận, không phải nó vào một vài chục triệu không ăn thua gì cả. Tụi Đài Loan, tụi Lăng Nhăng, không có đông cho đó, không có gì. Cái nghĩa là mình muốn hấp dẫn được nó để có những tư duyên đẹp. Nhà ở trên đó tôi bảo đảm đó, thì 5-10 năm rồi sẽ là 3-5 triệu cái căn hộ. Nó bán cho tụi ngoại quốc. Thôi
bây giờ mình đi ai rồi?
Hai người bạn nhé.